Hey everybody, welcome back to Doc's Autos. If you are new to the channel, please consider hitting subscribe and like below, share it with your friends. If you're returning, thank you very much. And don't forget, watch the video all the way through. It helps the YouTube gnomes know we've got good content over here and puts it out in front of more people. Today, we are working on the SM95, the good old Ford Mustang. We've got lots of stuff to do to it today. Also, excuse the background noise, I went out and ponied up for an air conditioner for the garage. You notice we're back in the garage today because the shop is still 90 plus degrees. At least up here, it's about 76 degrees, not nearly as humid, which is a giant bonus for me, and hopefully a bonus for you too, because nobody wants to see me sweaty. Today we have, like I said, the good old 98 Ford Mustang, and we have a bunch of parts in the back seat. Why? Because where else would you put your spare parts? We've got two front struts, two rear shocks, and new rear glass, and a new convertible top. Because if you remember from the very first video, or just look up here somewhere, the convertible top is pretty much toast. It's ripped and cracked and just no good. The glass is still good, fortunately, but you have to replace both pieces, especially if you're gonna be changing the color of your convertible top, which is what we're gonna do. So we're gonna get working on that right now and see how hard it is. I've tried to look around the good old interwebs and find out how you do this. And it doesn't look too easy, doesn't look super hard, but one of the reasons I was able to get this car for such an incredible price was that the dealer had quoted about $2,000 to replace the convertible top. So I found the top here, the Key Auto top, glass and roof for about $400 from CJ Pony Parts. It's the sailcloth. So I'll open it up here shortly and we'll look at it together. I haven't even opened up the box yet. So we'll take a look at that. So yeah, we'll see if it, how much of a pain it is to do. And I'm sure since we're up here where it's a little cooler, it'll be far less frustrating for me and far less of a colorful vocabulary. Alrighty folks, we are back here looking at the SM95 now and gonna look at getting this convertible top off. I did do quite a bit of looking around online and actually had to go through four or five different write-ups or pictures, illustrations and whatnot on how this actually comes off, because so many of them I found were either a complete frame off convertible top swap. It was the top with the vinyl one piece rear window. It was just the rear glass piece and not really the entire process start to end. So hopefully my goal is here to have a complete start to end for the roof and glass rear window, because that is a different process than the one piece roof with the vinyl insert in it. So our first step here is there is a number of Allens, or sorry, T-somethings, I'll find out in just a minute here, that we have to take off. These trim pieces come off on both sides, and then this front steel metal header piece comes off. And that's going to allow us to gain access to a number of staples under here that hold on this front piece. So that's what I'm going to work on first. Looks like these here are all going to be T10s along the top here. And then there's a pair of larger ones, which looks like they're T20s. Yeah, T20s for the side piece. And then this piece of trim will also come off. So let's go ahead and get all these off. Alrighty, so as I was saying, you've got a bunch of T10s right along the top of here. Let's go ahead and get those out. Let me run over here to this side first so we can see what I've got working. And I suppose for taking these off, I can make this a little easier on myself. Much easier. And then this trim piece here should come off. We can set him aside. I'm going to go over, take the trim piece off the passenger side. Then I'll work through all these little small bolts here, or screws. All right, all those four T20s are out. Now let's get all these T10s. All right, this piece should just come right off. There we go. Now, as I was saying, you can see all these staples in here, and you can see how nice the fabric was originally too. Anyways, we have all these staples in here, so I gotta go ahead and take all these out. I'm not gonna punish you all on camera with that, but I'll get the first couple out, show you how it's done, and then I'll just go ahead and knock the rest of these off camera. So pretty much get your screwdriver back behind these staples and pry out a little bit, you know, nothing to it. Except, you know, when I have one hand holding a camera and the other hand trying to fumble around with the staple. Let's go over here. There we go. You can see a lot of these will probably just come out pretty easily. If I had both hands free, it'd be a little easier to do. But you can kind of see what I'm getting at. And then once you get it loose or pulled out a bit, you can hit it with a needle-nose pliers and pull it out the rest of the way. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that all the way along here after I go and find my tools. Alrighty, next here we have two crossbars in the roof, and those are held on underneath here. Oh, if you can see, again, my wonderful lighting. They're held in here, and underneath the inner cover, there's a pair of, which of course, oh, maybe we can see one, there we go. A pair of those T20 screws. So they're on both sides, passenger and driver, front and rear on both of these crossbars. So we're gonna go ahead and take those off, and then that's gonna allow us to start pulling this back. There is a inner liner, which is stapled down, you can see here. And that's the inner liner here on the top, which I'm gonna try and leave and not pull down if I can help it. We will see. How about a Alrighty, now that we've got those screws off the front of here, we're able to peel the outer shell back. And while there is gonna be a cord, steel line, I'll show you here, steel line down in here, we're not saving this top, so we can just tear it. Because we'll be dealing with this later. Well, that's a wonderful little mess. And we can just start peeling it back from this side as well. That'll get us up to our first crossbar here. And again, we have some screws under here. See, I'm saving you the time of looking at all these different places for how to take this thing off. Yep, the new one does not have this inner liner in it, only the outer. So we have to be careful that we're not damaging this because it is actually attached to here. So we'll have to be careful on this. Case in point, not everything you see on the internet is true. Glad I looked at that before I just started tearing on stuff, because that would not end well at all. Actually got to collapse this down a bit. Alrighty, this is going to give me enough room to pivot this thing and unscrew that. Taking off my flip-flops. Knocking over the GoPro. Yeah, you survived another fall, buddy. Good job. Now, I'm trying to show you. So under here, we have a number of screws. It's like five of these. T, probably back to T20 screws. Yep, more T20s. So around the back here, we have this bar I was loosening up and taking the five T10s out of, whatever, or T20s out of. And that's gonna release this here, and this here, that inner liner, or headliner for inside, that's gonna release those two. So when I go to put the stuff back together, we do have this right here on the new one. So we just have to make sure we get everything sandwiched back in place in the right spot. So now we've got one more to do that to back here, and we'll keep working our way back. So we'll be right back. Alrighty, well, we've got these first two crossbars disconnected. Our inner headliner is safe. And now we come to our third bar here, and this has a ton of staples in it, holding in both the top, the rear glass, I believe, and the headliner. So we're gonna go ahead and start working through that. And I think this sheeting will also have to come off as well. We'll just take a look and see. So let's try and get some of these staples out. All right, so we're just gonna work our way across. Now remember, you don't wanna beat the crap out of this, because there's some other goodies under here that you don't want to damage, like I'm sure the, yeah, probably. This is tied in there somewhere, like I said, and just generally don't beat on it because we're probably going to need it later. So I'm going to keep going across the rest of this back. There's probably, 60 staples back here. And I've asked my wonderful wife to pick up an electric stapler from the Menard store on the way home, because I really don't want to staple in everything by hand. That just sounds like no fun. Alrighty, well, it's gonna be really tough to show you until I get this off, but down in here, I'm looking at the driver's side now. Down in here, there is a, I need lighting. There's the kind of the rear cover inside the vehicle that you pull. There's a little opening here that wraps around a little 9/16 trim nut. And I'll show you this once I get it out, but take off this trim nut, and then you'll be able to start working your way around the back to getting the rest of the vinyl top off. So we're gonna work on that. That's gonna be kind of challenging. Get my staple mess done. I'm gonna leave this here, actually. I think, yep, this is also gonna have to come off. because this attaches to our glass, where this part here is just for our roof itself. So I'm gonna come back and get this off, but I wanna try and get the part of the actual roof itself off and out of the way before I come back for the glass. But there should be a long bow behind here that holds this roof piece in. Alrighty, just wanted to show you where we're at. We did get the convertible top off, sitting over there. It was time consuming more than challenging. The biggest part was there's about 16 of these little nuts, these 9/16 nuts that are spun on. And it's easiest, you can get the ones along the side, there's four of them here. You can get those if you cut a hole in the old cover and sneak in. But all the ones in the back, about 10 of them, 8 or 10 of them, it's gonna be easiest to crawl in from the back seat and over the back. That's probably the easiest way to get to it. This back piece of trim comes off with about 8 or 9 different little Phillips head screws. And that holds these two trim pieces down. There's a little Phillips screw in here. And I need to figure out how to get these off fully yet, because there are three little clips under here that hold the convertible top on. That's kind of pinch clips. So I need to figure out how this comes off. And then the last thing is there is a spring in here that keeps the corner of the top taut and down in here. And I think you've got to go in through the side panel here to get it off. A couple of things I've found, I've just had a hook on it for the clip. This actually has more like a fishing lure type clip that rolls over and clasps itself, so it can't come undone, period. So just got to figure that out. And then these side wings for the rear, they screw in back here as well along this back plate. And I'll show you that as I get all that unstapled. A lot of staples to do across the back, across all of here, and a lot of lining up and fitting to do before we actually go ahead and start stapling anything down, because you want to make sure everything is lined up and centered when you start putting it back together, or your top's going to be not straight. Last thing to do here is take these wires. They are just held in place by a little pinch point here and here. Then we can take them up, because when we put our new convertible top on, we will put this tensioner back through the little channel in the top. So pretty much I'm going to play the game of cleaning up all of my old staples for right now. These are okay, these are going to stay on. And yep, front is good. I've just got staples to pull out of back here, and then the bars that hold the rear window in, those all have a number of staples in them as well. So I guess once you look in the back, there's plenty of space. Just a matter of getting everything lined up. This is that boot. Oh, ooh, my tools and all those little cover nuts. So these all screw back on here, that 9/16. And then this guy here goes and clips over here. So this is what I was trying to show you in the darkness over on that side. Much easier to show you in the light. Basically, these just clip over and are held up, separating the convertible top from your trunk space. So we'll go ahead and put those back on. I assume the process is going to be fit the glass on first, and then put this back on, and then work on fitting the actual convertible top itself, getting that lined up, tacked in, and then go and secure these down and finish up with the rest of the staples. But I'm gonna go ahead and prep everything else, get these tension cables pulled off, and get this back pile of staples cleaned up, because when the missus gets home with my new electric stapler, then we can start putting everything back together. So we'll come back then. So the name of the game here is we take this mounting bracket here, which goes in the car, mounted, of course, the direction of top. It's upside down now. And I've also taken and measured on the new roof This is the glass for the back window. I measured where center is. So our aim is we have both of these lined up where center is, but we have to staple from the back. And we start here and staple in and work our way around to create our correct, if I pull it a little closer, to wrap around the back here and get ready to start putting it back in the vehicle. Now there are some other side trim pieces that go on over here and over here, but we need to get the overarching roof piece itself into this mix too, because... All right, so here's just a Senco upholstery stapler. It does have the 3/8 inch staples in it now. Let me start with one of these clamps. There's our top, here's our center line. I'm gonna go in about to here and clamp it. Just take a look at how far. So if we're going flush, yep, we should be just flush with the fabric, and that'll keep us where we need to be on our line. We go ahead with our Sharpie and just draw the bottom here too. And there's a little room for adjustment, so exact precision is not totally required, but shouldn't be off by a ton. All right. Go ahead and give this a clamp here. And let's set a staple, see what happens. Oh, perfect, look at that. Right in. Go over here on this side. Oh yeah, that's gonna be a no-brainer. No-brainer. All right, so I'm gonna keep wrapping this around with a few tacks and see where we come up. All right, folks, before this gets too long, we're gonna cut it off here at the halfway point. And we come back, when we come back, we will be putting on the new top from ZJ Pony Parts. So hope you stay tuned for that. And if you have not yet again, hit that subscribe button if you like videos for DIY projects for working on classic cars, muscle cars, tractors, daily drivers, car-related content. If this stuff is interesting, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, puts our video out in front of more people. And again, until the next video, have fun doing what you're doing, and we'll see you coming back in part 2. Bye-bye.